Bonjour à tous. Good morning, everyone. I'm happy to be here with Deputy Prime Minister Freeland and Minister Ng, as well as Dr. Tam and Dr. Ngu. Canada has now passed a total of 200,000 cases of COVID-19 since the spring, with almost 22,000 active cases across the country today. Here and around the world, the fight against this virus is far from over. And in order to win it, we have to keep working together. Canada is a big country, and the pandemic is playing out differently in different provinces and territories. That's why I'm asking everyone to keep following the guidelines of their local public health authorities. This is a Team Canada effort. And when you wear a mask, limit your in-person close contacts, and use the free COVID Alert app, you're doing your part. As a government, we're doing ours too. Since March, we've received almost 800 million pieces of personal protective equipment, masks, gloves, gowns, and face shields to protect frontline workers and Canadians. This month alone, we've distributed over 20 million pieces of PPE to the provinces and territories. And we're continuing to work around the clock to ship even more to the front lines. Pendant qu'on fait tout ce qu'on peut pour que les Canadiens restent en santé, on continue de redoubler d'efforts pour que notre économie aussi reste en santé. Cette semaine, c'est la semaine de la petite entreprise. C'est l'occasion de reconnaître l'énorme contribution des petites entreprises à notre pays. Au cours des dernières semaines, j'ai eu la chance de parler avec plusieurs entrepreneurs ainsi qu'avec des dirigeants d'entreprises qui m'ont fait part de leurs suggestions et de leurs inquiétudes. Les petites entreprises sont au cœur de nos communautés et notre gouvernement est là pour elles. On est là pour des gens comme Charles-Hugo Boucher, du Café La Rue, dans mon comté de Papineau, pour qui le prolongement de la subvention salariale va lui permettre de garder des employés. Avec l'arrivée de l'hiver, plusieurs propriétaires d'entreprises espèrent que les clients ne seront pas plus rares s'il faut faire la file au froid à l'extérieur. Aux propriétaires de petites entreprises qui en ont besoin, la subvention salariale, la nouvelle aide d'urgence du Canada pour le loyer qui va directement aux entreprises locataires et le compte d'urgence pour les entreprises canadiennes sont des programmes qui sont là pour vous. Vous faites preuve de résilience et de créativité et notre gouvernement continuera de faire preuve d'audace pour vous soutenir. Small businesses are the heart of our communities and the backbone of our economy. During Small Business Week, I want to take a moment to recognize the hard work and perseverance that so many people put in every day, and especially over the last 6 months. Whether you've adapted your menu to make takeout easier or used your 3D printers to manufacture PPE, your resilience and creativity is an inspiration. As a government, our goal is to help you and your employees through this tough time. From the beginning of this crisis, we took immediate and significant action to help Canadian businesses keep their door open and their workers on the job. Recently, I spoke with many small business owners that shared their experience with me. Dr. Hedy Fry introduced me to Lisa Arthurs, owner of Quick Nickel Clothing in Vancouver's West End, for whom the new Canada Emergency Red Subsidy could provide direct help as she continues to work hard to keep her business running. Of course, the extended wage subsidy and the expanded Canada Emergency Business Account are also there to help. Moving forward, we will continue to listen to the needs of small businesses, just like we listen to the needs of all Canadians. We'll be there for people, whatever it takes, as long as it takes. Malheureusement, notre lutte contre la COVID-19 n'est pas terminée et il faut continuer d'écouter les consignes des autorités locales de santé publique. Portez un masque, téléchargez l'application gratuite Alerte COVID et limitez vos contacts avec les autres. Et pendant que vous faites des efforts tous ensemble pour ralentir la propagation du virus, pourquoi ne pas encourager les petites entreprises de votre voisinage pour souligner la semaine de la petite entreprise en commandant un repas au Resto du coin ou en achetant une carte cadeau à votre boutique préférée. I want to end this morning by taking a moment to talk about the Community Resilience Fund, which supports partnerships and innovation in countering online radicalization to violence. The pandemic has increased the amount of time we spend in front of our screens. And while the digital space is powerful, it's not without issues. Online hate is far too common, and all too often, it can spill over into real life. Better understanding violent extremism is key to preventing radicalization to violence, so that we can stop tragedies before they happen. So far, the Community Resilience Fund has supported 39 projects across the country with a total of over $29 million. Today, I can announce that we will invest in the YWCA Canada's project Block Hate, building resilience against online hate speech. This is an important project, and I know it will help keep our communities safer. To all the groups and local leaders who are part of this fund, thank you for your vital work. Merci.